Welcome to Cafe Enoma and welcome to our reaction to Bob Seger, and we are going to react to the song The Fire Down Below.
The last time I heard Bob Seger, I got very philosophical about things. I really enjoyed the song. In retrospect, I heard it a couple of times more and I loved it even more. So, you know, all the philosophical stuff I said, definitely try to make sense of it. Don't let it go over your heads and don't let it offend you in any way, because that's how we react to music. We keep it pure, raw, open, sincere, totally unscripted, always impromptu, always in the moment, always spontaneous basically, and that's so refreshing to find on a platform like YouTube, where almost every single thing, every single video is totally scripted, so fake, so manipulated, so unreal. So please give us the freedom to do our thing, even if at times it goes against your ethos, your guidelines, your upbringing, whatever you like. Yeah, that's fine, because the same goes with us. We are also raised in a different part of the world from you, probably different culture, different upbringing, styles, techniques that our parents used and now we use on our kids based. So it's all different. So obviously when you have an unscripted reaction, which is so, it's so strange on this platform, you know, it's so rare, it's so strange that people just can't stand it. People just can't stand looking at our faces. They just want to possibly harm us or get rid of us any way possible. They just can't take someone who's so honest and who does it the way we do it, because everyone else is following a formula. They are following the system, they are following the formula, they are following set patterns. We are unlike them. We are totally in the moment, like this reaction introduction. Totally unplanned, totally unscripted. I thought I'll just say, you know, compare it to the last video and then get started. But here I am talking about things again, how we are different. And it's important to mention these differences as much as we can, because only then you will understand that we are not here to, you know, mock, ridicule, belittle the musicians, though sometimes we do that. And we do that because we know the damage that song can do to millions of people who listen to it. People may not, thousands may not come and watch those reaction videos. But even then, if we can change the life of someone, or if we can make sure someone doesn't take up to the bottle or to the needle tomorrow, our job is done. I think we deserve a huge round of applause, which we give ourselves, because on this platform, those things don't happen. Those things never happen to people like us, because people like us don't exist on this platform till we came along. Didn't exist, rather. Anyway, having said that, Bob Seger, The Fire Down Below. Let's see what Kirti thinks about it all first, and then I'll add in, chip in later. So first time reaction.
Yeah.
Somebody right.
Beautiful, beautiful. This is the way to do it. This is the way to write a song. This is the way to talk about an issue like this. This is the right way to do it. Yeah. You know, beautifully, beautifully written, beautifully sung. Wonderful tune, nice guitar solo in there towards the end. Everything perfect, perfectly done in this song as per me. I would love to listen to this song many times over. Very well done, very well done. Yes, red light areas, prostitution, O-joints are all over the world. And it's apparently it seems to be very, very common in certain countries. And yeah, I mean, this is looking at the other side of it, all the different kinds of people, the clientele who go to these women, and nowadays in, of course, lots of men into the profession. So they go to them, whether it's a cop, it's a lawyer, banker, a lot of different kinds of people, different occupations, different age groups, maybe all of them going to these, you know, people who work on the streets at night, and some of them don't treat them right, you know. So that this song is addressing that issue, raising awareness about that issue, and doing it very well, very well. Yeah.
I like the way it was sung, and I like how the guitar tune, almost it's like completing his sentence at the end. The way it follows up after he stops singing a sentence, it follows up as if it is completing his sentence. There have been, I think, numerous shows made on these topics, and people have been aware of such things. But for some reason, whether the government or the people, organizations, volunteer organizations, etc., all around the world have not been able to put a cap onto these problems significantly. Maybe a little bit here and there, but not very effectively. And it still continues to be a major problem. Maybe nobody wants to help out as much as it should have been done. And that is the reason why it continues all over the world. The exploitation of the, I want to only say the women in this kind of profession, but also exploitation of the weaker of the society always happens no matter where you are. So first you are driven to certain places, and then after that it continues with you further. And you know, it's just an unbroken chain still. Today we are dealing with a pandemic, and we are hoping that people break the chain and this and that, when we haven't been able to do so many things which we could have done in the past as well. Those are pandemics as well. Nobody has been bothered about it, because just because it does not affect you, or it's not that contagious that in the air it is present, so you don't care about it. The moment it comes to every single person, that's when you are awakened. Otherwise, these kind of pandemics have been there throughout the world for centuries, and nobody really takes a significant step or a mass movement kind of a thing where people should not be allowed to be exploited the way they are. And it's a very, very, very dark place of the society, but people are comfortable in their own setups, and they don't mind, you know, dealing with things. Though with this song, I was also thinking about how the nights are spent around the world. You know, everywhere, different places. Of course, days are an active time of the 24 hours, but different places have different night activities also. And if you start comparing, it's completely different and vibrant around the world.
Yeah, and this song made me think a lot about the movie Equalizer, both parts, Equalizer 1 and Equalizer 2, starring Denzel Washington.
Washington, my favorite.
Yeah. One of my favorite actors.
He's my top 5 favorite actors.
Yeah, so this song definitely made me think about that, because that's a vital part of both parts, this issue. Yeah, so definitely thought about that, and this probably was way before that, I think, this song. Wonderfully written. Whoever's written this song, whether it's Bob Seger or anyone else, definitely did an outstanding job in putting it together the way was in this year, right here.
There was a beautiful movie from Chennai, I think. It was a short film, about 30 minutes or so. I don't even remember the name of the movie, but that was done so beautifully about one woman. And the way he was describing the street light, the night time, and especially the midnight time, that woman's face and the way it was all picturized, very simply done. I must get a hold of that movie again. It should be there on the net. Oh, hardly 30 minutes or something, but that was very striking. The way they had done it. Chennai is in India, if you don't know. Yeah, South Park.
Anyway, that's it for this one.
Thank you for watching.
Goodbye.